Hello everyone, I'm Ayushi. I'm currently interning under the Lexis & Company. Today I'm going to deal with the Transfer of Property Act, the section, section 10 and some like little bit of section 11, and we'll see the difference, and we are dealing with it for the knowing the information that if you are purchasing a plot of land, so is there any clause which is there in the section 10 or 11 which denies you for the enjoyment of the property, that if the transferee can put a clause or says that this is the clause, this is the limitation of this, you can't go beyond this. Like you can't, the transferee can't put a clause by saying that by restricting you for the enjoyment of your property, or can't put a condition to it. So section 10, which says that where property is transferred subject to a condition or limitation absolutely restraining the transferee or any person claiming under him from parting with or disposing of his interest in the property, the condition or limitation is void, except in the case of lease where the condition is for the benefit of the lessor or those claiming under him, provided that the property may be transferred to or for the benefit of the woman not being a Hindu, Muslim or a Buddhist, so that she shall not have the power during her marriage to transfer or change the same on her beneficial interest therein. So what means this? By the section 10, which means that there is an exception, two exceptions are there. Section 10 says that Section 10 says that declares a condition to be void when it is absolutely restrained alienation. Restraint or alienation is absolutely absolute if it totally takes away or curtails the right of disposal. So the restraint may be absolute as a restriction on the power of alienation in the point of time or as a particular or specified person, only for another form. Partial restraints are not prohibited. So the absolutely restraint is void. So the next, the partial restraint, that can be a valid and can be enforceable. So section 10 is very silent about the situation where the restraint is partial, where the restraint does not take away the power of alienation of the transferee substantially, but only limits to some extent. The restraint is partial. So in this situation, we can see that in a condition where a condition was included at the sale date that the property, imagine a situation in the sale date, it's written that you cannot transfer your property outside your family. So that restraint is like partial restraint, which is a valid restraint, but absolute restraint is not at all valid. It's a void ab initio, because he is having a full ownership towards that property, and full he can do with the property as he wants. So there are two exceptions to it. That is for the lease, and that is for the it's for the lease and for the married woman. So in the lease, if you are transferring lease is a transfer of limited interest, where a transferor reserves the ownership and transfers only the right of the enjoyment to the lessee. So therefore, the lessor can impose a condition that the lease, that he shall have no right to sublease or assign that if you are renting a property to someone, you are giving the possession of the property. But in that agreement, you can mention that you don't have a right to sublease or subrent that property. That is exception to this. So in another case, there is an exception in the married woman. So in the married woman, not including a Hindu or Muslim or Christian, because for those there is a particular laws, that is a Hindu marriage act. The personal laws are applied to those religions. For that, there is already a clause provided for the validity of restraint or alienation to the married woman to these communities. So for the married, so when a property is transferred to a married woman, the transfer can validly impose a condition restraining alienation. Such conditions shall not be void or under the section 10. So this is for the property. That is reason behind such a restraint is to safeguard the interest of the married woman who could be easily exploited to their unscrupulous husband. So we'll see the section 11, which says that section 11 says that restriction repugnant to the interest and created where on the transfer of property and interest therein created absolutely favor of any person, but the terms of the transfer direct that the interest shall be applied or enjoyed by him in a particular manner, he shall be entitled to receive and dispose of such interest as if there is no such direction. Which says that if you are purchasing a property, so if the person from whom you are purchasing transferee, he cannot impose the restriction or give that this is the way, this is the he cannot direct that this is the way you have to enjoy the property. He cannot restrain you from the enjoying the right, because that is the right of enjoyment, because that is the property. You are in a full possession to it, full ownership to it. Somebody from that you have purchased the property, he cannot put a clause by saying that this is the way you have to enjoy your property. You can even sell that property, mortgage that property, gift that property. You can enjoy your property whatever the way you want. But there is an exception to this clause, which says that when any such direction has been made in respect of one piece of immovable property for the purpose of securing the benefit enjoyment of another piece of such property, nothing in the section shall be deemed to affect any right which the transfer may have to enforce such direction, or any remedy which he may have respect of for such breach thereof. Which says that a condition or direction restraining the mode of enjoyment may make the transferor, provided it is for the beneficial enjoyment of transferor's own adjoining property. Imagine a situation. If A is a transferor, if he is transferring his property to B, so A can both the properties beside to it. So he can put a clause by saying that this is my the way, and you cannot build a home which will affect my enjoyment. He can absolutely do that. So this is an exception to it. If the condition has been imposed by the transferor himself, a condition imposed if he impose a condition that you cannot build a property which will obstruct the sunlight or sun rays to come enter into my property. So that clause which will be valid, because there is an another property which is the transferor. So he is in also position to it. He is a purchasing, he is a selling that property to another buyer. So he have to take property by seeing all this thing, and this is acceptable, and this will be valid. So section 10 says you about the disposal of the property, and section 11 says the enjoyment, the way of enjoyment of the property. Okay, that's it. Thank you.